Mrs. Margareta Gustafsson, who is also one important player from the SCA logistics and terminal manager here in the Umeå area. And Mrs. Gustafsson's important task is to offer the businesses efficient logistical solutions and secure transport on road, railroad, and shipping in to be a continuously attractive for the SCA customers. But Mrs. Gustafsson is also one of these persons that have been very deeply involved in developing the concept of the Midway Alignment of the Botnian Corridor project.
Yes.
To put in the business perspective, not only for SCA, but also for the general of the business sector, which has been very, very valued. So you're going to be two presentations.
Yes.
Okay, you're going to present yourself, so I leave the floor to you, please.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you for inviting us to this conference, and we are very happy to be here. And like Morten said, we have been in this project in the Midway Alignment for 2.5 years. And yes, my name is Margareta Gustafsson, and I worked in the port of Umeå as a terminal manager. And today we are two.
Yes, my name is Per-Anders Westin, and I work as a finance director in this SCA Logistics. So we are making a team presentation here.
Yeah. And we promise you we will show you a lot of slides to keep us awake before lunch. The agenda from us is that we want to tell you who we are. We want to present what we offer, the challenges we see in the company today, and also our aspirations and actions. So we are, SCA is a global hygiene and forest products company, and we are working globally, and we are 44,000 employees. The part that we are in, the division, is the forest products department. And we handle our forest holdings, that is close to 1.6 million hectares, and that makes us the largest private owner of forest in Europe. And from the forest, we provide our industries with raw material for production of paper and packaging, printing, pulp, solid wood products from our sawmills, and also, a very important part is this renewable energy, where we have the windmills in place on our forest land. And for the forest products group, the sales last year was 17 billion Swedish crowns.
And we can say also that, for instance, from all of these production units, we have also a very strategic part, and that is the logistic, to be able to transport the goods from the factories to the end customers in a very cost-efficient way. Mm. So that is a strategic decision to have that inside forest products.
Yes. So the thing is that we sort of coordinate and all the industry's production, but also it's very important to mention that 1/3 of our business is what we define as external business, and that is the important part of the industry in the north of Sweden, also in Finland, and partly also in Norway. So what do we offer? We have a marine transport, we had handling and warehousing, road transport and rail transport. And we work very much to improve and develop our transport system, for instance. I mean, this rail system, these rail cars, is something unique that we have developed within SCA Logistics that are special designed and optimized to take more cargo. And this system was started some 2 years ago, and we reduced emission and can deliver twice as much goods as we did before in stationary wagons. Mm.
And if we look on the marine transportation, we have both our own 3 ro-ro vessels, and we have also 2 container vessels on a long-time charter, so to say, and on a fixed schedule from northern parts of Sweden to Rotterdam, London, and that part of the continent. Mm-hmm. We have also our own terminals in Umeå, Sundsvall, Lübeck, Rotterdam, and London, and the annual volume is about 6.3 million tons in these terminals, and the square meters are about 300,000 square meters. So it's quite big operations that we have.
Yeah, and of course these terminals, they are now in these places because our sort of main market is Western Europe, but also a very important piece is Scandinavia. So this picture shows, I mean, where we operate, our own terminals, but also we have a lot of, connected terminals where we are integrated with our IT systems. And one important part here is Vasa, but we have also in Portugal. We have also terminals in Italy and in Dublin where we are connected, I mean, with the IT systems. And also shuttles, train shuttles from our port into Europe to Italy. And of course, it's not only that we are exporting from south to north. Our system are built up with that we have a full payload also for the northbound cargo.
Yeah. And I think also it's quite visible to see that we are the major or the biggest private forest owner in Sweden, and that kind of production from the plants must be transported to Europe and overseas in a very good way, and that is mostly on the marine side that is important to find good solutions.
Mm. And of course, it is the distance to the market that is the challenge. We have, I think, very good products. They are much appreciated from our customers, but we have to be, what is important is not only the infrastructure in the ports, it also the infrastructure from the hinterland in Sweden, and that we have good connection both on rail and road to actually be able to compete. And we can see that the forest industry creates a lot of jobs. We have heard that before from Komatsu and Indexator, and we are, I hope, a big customer to both companies.
So our aspirations is to connect the northern Sweden to mainland Europe. That is, of course, important for us. And to increase the production, we know that we have an increase in our production in the Sundsvall area in a new pulp mill that is during construction, and that will increase the volumes, or more or less double the volumes in the Sundsvall area regarding pulp, from about 450,000 tons to about 900,000 tons, or even up to 1 million in the long run. So we know that we have an increase of volumes.
Mm. And that is, I think that is really important, that we believe in this area. We believe that we can have a strong industry. We work very hard to find cost-efficient solutions for distribution and so on. So the investment, I mean, in this plant is 8 billion Swedish crowns,
yes,
which is a huge investment, we think, and we are very happy to be part of that. So this map, it shows, well, the present distribution we have on the seaside. We have also railway shuttles and so on, but this is the way we operate with our vessels today.
Mm. And some of the actions that we are having or planning is to increase the containerized cargo and to improve the container handling in the ports and in the terminal areas, and also in cooperation with the municipality of Sundsvall and the port of Sundsvall, to plan a logistic village and a container port and a deep sea quayside for bigger container vessels.
Mm.
And also the Swedish railway transport administration to plan for hinterland connections in a good way.
Yeah. What we see as a challenge is when we are coming down with our cargo in this area, is that we are working very much to find these hinterland solutions where we have more of transit from the ports and down to our customer base in Europe, and to have a more of an intermodal setup, and also to use less cars on the roads where it's so crowded in Europe. So that is also a aim for us.
This is a picture of the Sundsvall area, and to the right you can see the existing terminal with the sheds, and there we are improving the port facility and the terminal facility in productivity, etc. And in the middle you can see the planned new container quayside with the deep sea functionalities, but you can also see the area for the new logistics operations to the left-hand side, and a new terminal, combi terminal. But as you can see, we have a considerable growth in percentage in regarding the TEUs that we have from last year and that we are planning within a few years ahead.
Okay.
This is the Rotterdam terminal that we have in the central part of Rotterdam. It's also a considerable growth, but we are also today having a large number of containers than compared to Sundsvall. But still it's a growth, and we need also to improve the terminal logistics and in that part. And this is also a small picture of the terminal area with both a ro-ro ramp and container areas and warehousing facilities.
And like all have mentioned, of course, very high on the agenda, everything we work with is with the focus of less emissions and, of course, sustainability. What we have done now, we have changed pretty much on our distribution system. We are moving goods from our ro-ro vessels to more containerized, larger vessels, and we see that the emission is then reduced by 21%, and with the volume growth that we see from our industries and also with larger vessels, in 2020 we will be able to reduce the emission with 33%. And a little bit about the business case. This is very close to my heart. Talk a little bit about Umeå more, and also Vasa. That's where I live. And for us, the ferry is very, very important because our industry has a large percentage of our business in Finland. So today we deliver some 60,000 tons to Vasa. And of course, it's important for us also that we are connected to Europe. For example, this cargo, picture from Vasa Port, it is steel produced in Germany by our terminal in Rotterdam, on our loading on this cassette system, like that our ro-ro vessel is a cassette system. It comes to Port of Umeå, no discharge, no nothing. We take it out from our own vessels, and 3 hours later, it's on its way to Vasa, and then to the final customer. So whatever the customers is asking for, a door-to-door delivery, or just to the terminal, or whatever, that is something that is included in our business. And this picture actually shows the SCA production, our paper reels. It's the same system. We put it on cassettes, we put it on the ferry, and we leave these machines in Umeå and discharge in Vasa. But the ferry today doesn't allow us to utilize, the full payload of the cassettes. It's limitation in weight and height and things like that. So if we see in the future a new ferry, we will be able to use less resources and be more efficient. But what I think is more important is that a couple of years ago, We were not that self-confident in SCA to continue the business in Finland like we would like to. And why was that? It was because during the winter we had so much problems actually to reach our customers. And from our terminal in Vasa, we have a 24 commitment for delivery. We couldn't keep up to that. So what did we do to solve that? Yeah, we have to take it by truck up all the way to Finland and down again. Not cost efficient, more emission, and not a happy customer. But since Vasa Line has started now for 2 years, we are more confident, thanks to Vasa Line, to continue this business. And here we can see one of Komatsu's machines that we are loading on the Vasa ferry. And also some 2 years ago, the municipality of Umeå has electrified the railway tracks all the way to the ferry, so we have a possibility now to work in a more intermodal way, but it's still, we need a more efficient way to work there. And finally, a picture of the port of Umeå. And like in Sundsvall, with a strong industry, growing volumes, more containerized, we see that we will increase the container volumes with 110%. And to be cost efficient and have a good possibility to grow with our customers, we also need to have more of these infrastructure investments, not only in the port, but also to connecting railway and roads. This is a picture of our Ro-Ro vessels and on our way to connect north of Sweden and Finland with Europe. Thank you.
Thank you for...